girl. But imagine if you had twins. Imagine if you had twins. One boy, one girl. Yeah, one boy, one girl. What would you name them? No. If you have twins. If you have a twin, boy and girl.
That's still a lie.
Well, they both start with an A.M.
12, 3, 11, 3, 10, 3, 9, 3, 8, 7, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8
Thank you, David, and thank you. You sound good. And most of you look good. Amen? Amen. Amen. Thank you for being here this morning. Here's what I want you to do. I want you to just go ahead and give the Lord a round of applause for what's about to happen here this morning. I've been able to sneak around and look at some of the practices and see, we're going to be blessed. This is going to be good. You're going to be glad that you came this morning, and we're glad that you came here this morning. I want to give you just a couple of announcements, and then I will get out of the way. Of course, we're having our children's Christmas play here in just a few minutes. I invite you to come back tonight for our Gifts for Jesus. Now, I know a lot of you are visiting. You're going, I don't know what you're talking about, Brian. How many of you ever had a high school talent show? Do you remember those? Okay, let me go back to people my age. Anybody remember the Gong Show? All right, you're going to want to be here for this. We're going to have some people that are giving their talents for the Lord. Some of it will be funny. Some of it is really, it's all good, but some of it is really good. And you need to come back tonight. Free meal. Come be with us. I think we're having barbecue.
Bring your pocketbook.
And bring your pocketbook. We're having a year-end donation for our building fund, okay? So come be a part of that and bring your talent. Have we got a full bill tonight? Is it really? It's going to be great. So come back tonight at 6 p.m., please. And then next Sunday morning, guess what that is, children? It's Christmas. Christmas morning, okay? We will be having an abbreviated service at 11 a.m. here at the church next Sunday, okay? So come out for that. And then on New Year's Eve at 11:45 to just a little tick after midnight, we're going to be having a prayer service. We're going to be praying in the new year. Folks, I can't think of a better way to start the new year than in the Lord's house, praying for the year, praying for our families, praying for our churches, praying for one another. Please come out and be a part of that, okay? All right, I think that's all the announcements that I have. Let me ask you one more question. If there's anybody here that came in these doors today with a burden, a worry, something you need prayer for or about, would you raise your hand right now? Unspoken requests are what I'm looking for. Yes. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father, we thank you for today. We thank you for allowing us to assemble ourselves together here on this beautiful Lord's Day to celebrate the birth of your Son, Jesus Christ. Father, we pray that you would bless these presenters this morning, Father. These adults and children that have worked so hard, just bless them, Lord, Father. Bless us as a congregation, as a church, Lord, Father, and let us be a blessing to you today. We pray for those who are sick and afflicted, anyone who's hurting today. Father, I pray for every person who just raised a hand. You know what they're worried about. You know what they're facing. You know what they're going through, Father. I pray, Lord, that you would just bless them as only you can. Father, again, we thank you for this day and this time together. We thank you and we praise you. In the name of Jesus, we pray. And everyone said together, amen. Amen. You may be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my privilege to introduce you to the children's play this year, All About That Baby.
That day began, just like any other day. I woke up early and was leisurely strolling through the fields to take my turn watching the sheep. Okay. I had intended to get up early, but as usual, things weren't going quite like I'd planned. I know. It's hard to believe, but I wasn't always the polished, respected shepherd I am today.
Oh, sorry. I'm just running a little late. There sure are a lot of people traveling today.
It's the census. We all become by degree of Caesar Augustus. I'm doing it. This is my little Simone.
Want to stay and play with us?
It's sorry. I gotta go watch my sheep. Nice to meet you. Gotta go.
What I didn't know was that day it set into motion events that would change the course of my life and of history.
In the sin.
Where is Nathaniel? He's late. He was supposed to be here when the sun was there, and now it's there.
Don't be so hard on him, Abigail. You know he gets distracted. Besides, I like having a break. Being out here in the fields, I think it's peaceful. There's enough to do helping Mom at home. I can just sit back, relax, and...
That is my sister. Everyone in my family helps out in the pasture. They're on the early morning shift.
Ooh, sorry.
Oh, there you are, Nathaniel. How was your trip through town? I bet it was better than your latest trip over the sheep. I heard people have been arriving by the hundreds. More people than I've ever seen.
I tripped over some nice kids. Joanna and Simone. They're here for the census. But on to more important things. The sheep. How's Max's foot? Has Beatrice been getting enough exercise? I promised JoJo that I'd help him stretch out his left hind foot. He entered it last week in our self-defense class.
They're sheep, Nathaniel. You talk about them like they're your friends.
What? They're just sheep, Abigail. Don't be crazy. What kind of person would be friends with the sheep?
I was friends with the sheep. I had the greatest adventures with them. For me, it was all about those sheep.
Well, have fun with your friends, Nate. We'll be back when the sun goes down.
I had a peaceful, easy feeling with my sheep. I mean, I knew they couldn't actually talk, but when I looked into their eyes, it was like I could almost understand or almost hear what they were thinking.
I know what you're thinking, that it's not a possibility. Sheep could be talking or telling a story.
Here we are saying that a sheep is so dim, so the chance have any opinion is slim.
Shepherd, and we like him a lot. He's a little goofy, but give him a shot. He's always looking out for us. He seems so reliable, but we don't want to scare him because he seems so excitable.
Hey, Max, how's it going? What's on your mind? You can't wait to get a haircut? Great idea, buddy.
We talk about sheep stuff. Sheep stuff. Talk about sheep stuff. When you feel really lonely or you're getting kind of blue, just look to the shepherd who is watching over you. Put your trust in the one who is faithful and true. Keep walking in his footsteps, he'll show you what to do. That's the wisdom of sheep stuff.
Before I knew it, my shift was over, and I was running back through town, thinking about the great meal I was about to have.
Well, running shepherd alert, you really don't stand still long, do you?
Nathaniel, can we come on and join you? I'm bored.
Well, I'm just on my way home to eat supper.
We have some leftover food. Would you like some? We're staying right here at the inn. We're lucky to get a room. Actually, the innkeeper told Pop is the busiest he's seen in years.
Well, I guess I could eat with you. And then take you to see my sheep.
Sheep, sheep, see the sheep.
She just wants to avoid going to bed.
Simone eventually convinced me. And soon we were walking back to the fields under a deep, dark blanket of night.
You're gonna love my flock. Now Beatrice, she's the feisty one. But then there's Max. He's so cool the others all follow his lead. Oh, and JoJo. He's just so funny.
I could talk about my sheep all day. But little did I know, something unbelievable would happen that night.
So
So I thought I'd try, you know, what harm could I try a different style? A shirt I could add a few inches and I could really elongate my midriff.
Beatrice, are you talking about that botched hairstyle you tried last season? It looked like you got hit by lightning.
It's called a crimper knot, boys. It was totally on fleece.
On fleece?
It's the latest thing. I heard it will catch on soon. But anyways, crimp wool was fashioned in the fall. Ask anyone. As for the wool treatment, I had mud imported from the pasture at Lambton Abbey. If Beau hadn't let the mud in so long, I'd be the top faster new shirt in the field.
You were certainly the dirtiest. It was bad.
It was supposed to evaporate. It was supposed to
Sorry, I'm you, plugs in. What's happening?
What is that?
Oh. What's that? This new technique I learned at Sheep Defense Guy. Move as one, left, right. At the Sheepinator, move as one, left, right.
I feel silly.
Glory to God. Glory to God, sing Gloria, glory to God. Glory to God, sing Gloria.
It's not working, there are more of them appearing.
Sway faster!
Gloria.
Extraordinary.
We're going to see this baby, right?
I don't know. It sounds like a risky journey.
After seeing that, I don't know if we can stay here much longer. Plus, I bet our main man Nathaniel would want to go see the baby. We'll stick with him.
Are your sheep okay? They haven't moved in a while.
Hey, little buddies. Everything all right? Max, Beatrice, Cece, JoJo?
Bah!
Oh, they were just scared. Don't worry, guys. You're safe and sound.
Bah!
Did we really just see that?
Were those real angels, or am I having a seriously weird dream?
They were definitely angels, but what was even more unbelievable was the announcement of the Messiah to be born as a baby.
I wouldn't believe it if I hadn't seen it for myself.
Yes, everyone will know when the Messiah has arrived.
Definitely. The prophets say that he will bring a new kingdom.
But the angels said that the Messiah is a baby. Could that be true? What if he isn't supposed to lead a battle on this earth? What if it's all about that baby?
Could it be, oh could it be, that God never planned to send a Savior in a conquering king? Could it be, oh could it be, what we've been waiting for, our expectations were wishes and dreams?
We gotta go see him. What are we waiting for?
Let's think this through. Do we really know what we just saw?
I know I was feeling pretty hungry. Maybe we imagined it.
I mean, people will think we're nuts if we go in running into town talking about angels.
But the angels entrusted the good news to us.
Listen, Nathaniel. People already think you're crazy. But me, I still have a chance.
That's true. They call you boy who talks to sheep.
Baa!
I'm out. I gotta go eat.
I'll go with you.
Well, I am in. We have got to go tell people about this baby.
I'm in, too. This is the most exciting thing that's ever happened.
I'm with Boy Who Talks to Sheep. We've got to go see this baby.
But Nathaniel thinks that we should stay here. How could we convince him? Right now, the shiny guy said king. Did they? They said king. And I cannot go see a king without at least a little preparation. See, Bo, give me my crimper.
Again with the voodoo? Have you learned nothing?
Well, I'm smart enough you don't see a king without at least a little preparation.
Look, something's happening with Nathaniel.
Abigail's right. I'm already the laughingstock of the town. Plus, I gotta take care of the flock. Beatrice hasn't been looking very well.
Not looking well. That's the last time I defend you, buddy. You know I'm not getting my usual time to sleep. I'm getting that. And you know now is just till she's buddy. I'm working on impossible conditions here. And if you think that.
It's okay, old girl.
That?
For once, I was going to follow some good advice. I would stay in the fields and take care of my ailing sheep. I was always too impulsive, and I needed to be responsible. The baby could wait. What we didn't know was that far off in the east, wise men had seen a star and wondered what it could mean.
A star in the sky like I've never seen before. Must mean a miracle. A miracle is waiting for me. A star in the sky like I've never seen.
has been a miracle. A miracle is waiting for the world.
I don't care if these humans have gone crazy. Some glowing angel beings appeared to all of us, so we're going to see what they're talking about. It's decided. We're going to see that baby.
Yippee! But Nathaniel seems we should stay here. How can we convince him?
We can try to sheep later again.
I don't think so, JoJo. Let's just try to communicate with him. Sometimes I think he can understand us.
But what if he doesn't?
Then we go with plan B. But let me try first. Nathaniel. I really think we should go see the baby like the angel said. It could be one of the greatest moments in history, and I don't want you to miss out on.
Love you too, buddy.
Plan B then?
Plan B. When I give the signal, take off running in the direction the angel said to go. But only if I give the signal. I'll shout, "Find that baby."
Oh, let's try to convince him one more time all together now.
Be my guest.
And suddenly, the strangest sound came out of Max.
Bah, bah, baby.
Amazingly, it seemed that my favorite sheep had known what to do when I did not. They went to find the baby, and so we followed.
Come on.
will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time on and forever.
That night, the Savior of the world was born into the stable, and we were the first ones to see him. Nearly 2 years later, the wise men would arrive after their long journey, but we never forgot the chance to be among the first ones to know God's precious gift.
In the bleak midwinter, all creation groans.
And in a world of darkness, frozen like a stone,
light is
So you see, it was really a night to remember, a night that would change the course of history. Hope was born into a world that desperately needed it. Oh, Max, I wish you could understand what really happened. It changed everything.
the shepherd who is watching over you. Ba-ba, ba-ba, ba-ba. Trust in the one who is faithful and true. Keep walking in his footsteps, he will show you what to do. Ba-ba, ba-ba, ba-ba. That's the wisdom of the sheep, so. Sheep stuff. Yeah, sheep stuff. The wisdom of sheep stuff. We're talking about sheep stuff. Sheep stuff. Yeah, sheep stuff. We're talking about sheep stuff.
That night, Jesus was born, and my life was forever changed. I'm ready to tell the world, it's all about that baby.
All about that baby. All about that baby. We believe the angel story, and we will give him glory. This baby is a king. It changes everything. All about that baby.
We'll never be the same.
All about that baby.
We'll never be the same.
What's it all about? All about, all about. What's it all about? All about that baby. What's it all about? All about, all about. What's it all about? All about that baby. What's it all about? All about, all about. What's it all about? All about that baby. What's it all about? All about, all about. What's it all about? All about that baby.
Seth and Michaela Melton as Joseph and Mary. Rylan Burroughs, Chandler Burroughs, Paisley Dixon, Elise Dixon, and Raylan Ortiz as the Angels. Oliver Rhodes, Gabe Overcash, and Jackson Guppy as our wise men. Kinsley Lance playing the part of Abigail. Noah Hamilton as Judah, and also his little sister Miriam's part, Ashley. We're so sorry you're sick. We miss you. We love you. All right, guys. Keaton Tate, Levi McCall, Caroline Rhodes, and Carter Lance as the best sheep this side of Bethlehem. Joanna and Simone, played by Emma Rhodes and Joanna Tate. Brian Rhodes playing the part of older Nathaniel. Our main man, Nathaniel, played by Gareth Tate. Our awesome adult choir, thank you so much for helping us out. Stephanie, we missed you. And the people who make us all look and sound good, our audiovisual team, Brian Hamilton, David Tate, and Jeremy Jones. Thank you, guys.
Y'all got really come on. I'll hear some woo woos. There you go. Oh man, I had a bird's eye view. I was up with the sound guys, and they had a hard time doing their job because I was going, "That's so awesome! Look at that! Look at her singing and look at him doing it." It was so good. There's two people they didn't mention. I want them to come up on the stage. Miss Stephanie Tate, come on up. And Miss Donna Overcash, come on up. They've worked so hard. There's other parents that's you've done so much, and we really, really appreciate that. I think Kinsley wants to say a word or two.
from all of the kids' play practices and all of your hard work. Oh, where'd Stephanie go? Thank you. Thank you guys so much for all your hard work that you've put into this play. We so much appreciate it, and it would not be without you guys.
Another round of applause. Amen. Amen. This is so good. I'm speechless. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for coming out today. I'm going to ask our actors to stay up on stage for a few minutes because I know that you'll want to get some photographs, some autographs, you know, some family. So, guys, stay up here, please. Let your families come up and just love on you and take some pictures and stuff like that. Okay? All right. Appreciate you being here so much. Thank you for coming out this morning. Let's close in a word of prayer, and then we will conclude. Lord Father, we thank you for this presentation. We thank you, Lord Father, for the presentation of the gospel. It is all about Jesus. It's all about him, Father. Without your Son, there is no hope. Without your Son, there is no eternal life. And so, Father, we thank you for sending your Son to be born, to live among us, to show us what you are like, that you are loving and that you are kind and that you are true and that you are a Savior who cares for your creation. Thank you, Father. Lord, we just love you today. And Father, thank you for letting us again gather here. And we just praise you, Father. We praise you. Thank you for Christmas. It's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. From the Mount Moriah family to you, Merry Christmas, everyone.